Arthritis is not a disease, but it is just a symptom. There's a belief in the community that this arthritis doesn't have treatment. It's a wrong concept. So if someone has pain and swelling in the joints, you tell the person has arthritis. More than 150 diseases can present with pain in the joints. What will happen then? The pain will go, but the internal disease will keep on worsening. But most 99% of the back pains are mechanical and can be corrected with proper exercise. A lot of times we keep hearing that I have arthritis, and people think that arthritis is a disease. That's a wrong concept. Arthritis is nothing but an English term for pain and swelling in the joints. So if someone has pain and swelling in the joints, you tell the person has arthritis. Arthritis can be a symptom of variety of diseases. More than 150 diseases can present with pain in the joints. If I can tell you an example, if someone has fever, it can be due to a variety of causes, starting from viral fever to dengue to pneumonia to meningitis to cancer. So if we keep taking, somebody has fever, and if we keep taking paracetamol, the cause of fever is not found. So if the person has meningitis, it will worsen and it can lead on to the death of the patient. Similarly, if someone has fever, what should we do? We should go to a doctor and find out what the cause of fever is. If someone has pain in the joints, go to a rheumatologist and find out what is the cause of joint pains. Why the person has arthritis? As I told you, arthritis can be a manifestation of more than 150 diseases. The most common diseases which is seen in our community are rheumatoid arthritis or osteoarthritis or gout or chikungunya arthritis or lupus. These are some of the causes why the person has arthritis, can present with joint pains. Similarly, joint pain can also be a manifestation of some of the viral diseases, some of the cancers. So what is most important is to understand that arthritis is not a disease, but it is just a symptom of an internal disease, or it's a red signal the body is giving us and telling us, find out what is wrong with you. But most of the time, what do? We go to the neighboring medical shop and keep taking painkillers. What will happen then? The pain will go, but the internal disease will keep on worsening and the joints will get damaged. Another big misconception in our community is arthritis is a disease of elderly. Although some of the arthritis like osteoarthritis and wear and tear arthritis is more common in elderly, but arthritis can affect because of any of these diseases, lot of diseases I told you, some of the diseases can affect very young age to as young as 2 years to 80-year-old man. What are the common types of arthritis what we see in community? The most common is, I told you, rheumatoid arthritis and osteoarthritis. Broadly, the arthritis can be classified into two types, inflammatory and non-inflammatory. Inflammatory means there is swelling in the joints. Non-inflammatory means most of them is a wear and tear. So what are the type of inflammatory arthritis seen in our community? Most common is rheumatoid arthritis. Other one is lupus. There is another type of arthritis called gout, which is because of the rise in uric acid level in the body. There is another one called lupus. Lupus is one of the arthritis which affect the multiple organs in the body. There is another arthritis called ankylosing spondylitis, which affect the back. So there are a variety of diseases, especially inflammatory diseases, which can cause arthritis. Most of the inflammatory diseases, why they cause arthritis is because of the dysfunction of immune system, or they are called autoimmune disease. In these diseases, the immune system starts acting against the self and keeps attacking each one organ of the body, and the joint gets swollen and get damaged. On the other side, the non-inflammatory arthritis is otherwise called osteoarthritis. Osteoarthritis is because of wear and tear, and it is caused by most of the time overweight or lack of exercise. So there is no single solution for any of this, all this arthritis. First thing, find out what is the cause of arthritis, which disease is causing arthritis, and then you think how to treat it. For example, the inflammatory arthritis, the symptom wise, the most important symptom is when they get up in the morning, they will have pain and swelling in the joints. So it's called early morning stiffness. And as the day improves, the pain will come down and the swelling will come down. Along with that, they can have fever, they can have fatigue. But the most important thing is early morning stiffness. In the non-inflammatory arthritis, like osteoarthritis, it usually affects the old age and the most common joint involved is knee joint. They have pain on activity. When they walk or they climb the stairs, they will have pain. So by symptom itself, we can understand whether it's inflammatory arthritis or non-inflammatory arthritis. Among inflammatory arthritis, which joints are involved, which systems are involved, based on that, you can classify which type of arthritis is there. Most of the inflammatory arthritis, the management, as I told you, most of them are autoimmune. You need to modulate the immune system to such a way that the immune system starts functioning normally. There's a belief in the community that this arthritis doesn't have treatment. That's a very, very wrong conception. It's a wrong concept because people think that arthritis, you have to take painkillers. That is a wrong, extremely, it is far from truth. Patients with arthritis, if diagnosed correctly and treated correctly, can be managed without painkillers and steroids. There are a lot of new drugs which have come up, with which we can control the disease very well. Another common problem, musculoskeletal problem seen in the community, is backache. Most of the backache is because of the poor posture or lack of exercise. Because our back muscles don't have enough strength, what happens? Discs bulge and there will be mechanical issues in the back. So the first and foremost thing to avoid the back pain is to proper exercise. But there are back pains which can be serious also. If somebody has an early morning pain, night pain, weight loss, then you have to be immediately sure to a doctor. Take an x-ray or do some investigations. Based on that, we can diagnose properly what is the cause of this back pain and correct it. But most, 99% of the back pains are mechanical and can be corrected with proper exercise. So, three key takeaways are, first, arthritis is not a disease, but it's a symptom. So, whenever somebody has pain in the joints, first and foremost is to find out why there is pain in the joints. Some of this can be easily, will go away in a couple of days, but some of them are going to last long. And it is not possible for a person by himself to understand what is the cause of joint pain, so you should go to a rheumatologist. Once the diagnosis is correctly done, the treatment is simple, and most of the time simple and straightforward, and it can be very well treated so that there is no damage in the joints. Thank you.